Michael! Dead!
Find Zedekiah. Find his family.
Yes, sir.
There's a price for betrayal.
Don't worry, my boys. We're safe now.
Into exile, a 500-mile journey east to Babylon.
No! No!
Zedekiah is the last of King David's descendants to reign.
Move it.
The Israelite monarchy ends here. Jeremiah is one of the few to escape. He heads to Egypt, never to return. The people have lost their prophet, their city, and their king.
You there! On your feet!
This is where I live.
Come on!
Come on! We pray!
The Jewish nation needs a different kind of leader to survive in Babylon. A man like Daniel. Daniel has visionary powers and is forced to work in Nebuchadnezzar's court.
Has no one anything to tell me? Can you not even describe my dream?
Silence is no answer.
You're supposed to be wise men, sorcerers, seers. So what do you see?
Sire,
Forgive me. No one here can read your mind.
Then what use are any of you?
My God can. He has shown me your dream.
Then you will be able to tell it to me. Every detail.
You saw a giant statue of a man. Its head made of gold. Then a giant stone struck the statue, smashing it to pieces.
I know that much! What does it mean?
The statue represents the empires that will follow yours. Yours is the greatest. The head of gold.
And the star that destroys the statue.
That is the kingdom of God. In the future, God will reign over all the world. Forever.
Destroyed by God.
Yes, sire.
What's your name?
Daniel.
You're a brave man, Daniel. I value that. You will serve me.
Just do as they say.
Before we ever return to Jerusalem,
Jeremiah promised that one day we would.
In the meantime, what do we do? Just bow our heads and serve this monster? I can't do it anymore.
Think about our people, Azariah. As long as we're in the king's court, we can help them. Imprisoned or dead, we can't.
Nebuchadnezzar destroyed God's temple, forced us into exile. My name is Azariah, he who is helped by God. Well, I call upon God to help me now.
He'll kill you if you won't bow.
I will not worship that.
We follow you.
Bow your heads!
And seek your presence.
With all my heart, I follow you. I fear you. I seek your presence.
Bring them!
Oh, my friends. Your faith will be tested now.
Daniel! What's wrong with them? Why will your friends not bow to me?
I assure you, sire, they will serve you faithfully. All their lives, as I will, but...
But
they will only worship God.
I will make them bow.
We follow you, we fear you, we seek your presence. With all our heart, we follow you, we seek your presence.
You.
When we wish to bend something that is hard and unyielding, what do we do with it? We put it into the fire.
Majesty,
take him!
We hear you, and we seek your presence.
Burn them!
Majesty, no!
Burn them!
What?
No!
bring oil!
Come! Please
come!
Save me.
Fire! Bring me fire!
Hear my cry. Thoughts of death entangled me. The anguish of the grave consumes me. Do not ignore my tears. I am overcome by sorrow. I call upon the name of the Lord! Lord, save me!
My enemies will be dead. They will turn back in shame.
Why do they not burn?
People of Judah, rise! God is with us! He's with us! God is with us!
The miracle in the fire unites the Jewish people. Far from allowing their faith to weaken in exile, they reaffirm their trust in God. The laws and histories that Moses received on Mount Sinai are preserved and compiled with the books of Joshua, Samuel, and Kings. Together, they form the heart of the Hebrew Bible. The Jewish people have their faith, but they're still prisoners. And the only man who can set them free has lost his mind.
So here you are, Nebuchadnezzar. Greatest king and lowliest man on God's earth. See, where your pride has brought you and us. You could have set us free. Now we are as trapped as you.
Thank you.
Within a few years of Nebuchadnezzar's death, a massive army approaches Babylon, led by Cyrus, king of Persia.
Let them know we've arrived.
The Babylonians know they don't stand a chance. They let Cyrus in without a fight.
Set us free if the prophecy's right.
To protect his fellow Jews, Daniel befriends Cyrus and continues to interpret dreams.
What does your dream mean, Daniel?
It's not my dream, sire.
There's a prophet here in Babylon, Isaiah. He says,
"Here's a king whose right hand I take hold of to subdue nations before him. He
is Cyrus. He names you, sire. It means God is with you."
I think you flatter me. But no one has ever died of flattery.
Your Majesty has done many great things,
as the record will show. As it should.
I am Cyrus, king of the world. Hangs on Daniel's every word like he has lost the power to think for himself. Daniel must be removed. One month without prayer. Surely only a traitor would object.
I cannot go back on my word. I promised them freedom to worship.
It is merely a test of their loyalty. They have had so many rulers. We wanted to make sure they saw you as the final, ultimate, king of the world.
One month without prayer. It probably sounds reasonable to Cyrus, but they know we can't comply.
They don't care about the king. They just want as much power over him as they can get. Which means they need you out of that way.
It's a trap for all of us. They want us dead.
A whole month. What will you do?
I don't know. But I do know I can't live long without praying to God.
Save me, O God, by your name. Have mercy on me. According to your unfailing love. Create in me a pure heart, O God. And renew a steadfast spirit within me. Do not cast me from your presence or take your Holy Spirit from me. But restore to me the joy of your salvation. And grant me a willing spirit to sustain me.
For disobeying Cyrus, Daniel is arrested and sentenced to death. Next morning, Cyrus realizes he's made a terrible mistake.
Sire, are you unwell?
I haven't slept. Please, God, I'm not too late.
Sire, shall I call the physician?
I have wronged my friend! Open it.
Is with you. Your God is real. Your God has saved you.
Yes.
I am Cyrus, king of the world, and my judgment is this. Your people shall return to Jerusalem.
Their God will be pleased. Though, sadly, they no longer have a temple to worship him in.
Throw him in with the lions.
Do you know what this is?
Oh. It's from the temple in Jerusalem. It's beautiful. You know, I've never seen it used.
And staying here in Babylon, I suppose now I never will.
But our children will. When they get to Jerusalem, when the temple is rebuilt and our nation is restored, our struggle is over.
There's something I need to show you.
Come with me.
Look. Our people are heading home. After decades in exile, moving as one, with hope and purpose. They've waited so long for this. But I fear for their future. I had a dream. I saw a great beast. Dreadful and terrible and unimaginably strong. It had great iron teeth. And it devoured the whole world. But God will not abandon us. I saw a great new leader. In my dream, there before me was one like a son of man, coming with the clouds of heaven. He was given authority, glory, and sovereign power. Nations and men of every language worshipped him. This isn't the end, Azariah. It's the beginning.
The Jewish people will need help to survive what is coming. Over the next 500 years, their tiny nation is attacked again and again. Then they succumb to the might of Rome.
Get in line!
Roman greed. Roman law. Roman punishment. Israel suffers like never before. Every day, the people pray for a new King David to lead them to salvation.